is yet to fall here at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia. Coming up, an important divisional round matchup in the NFC between the San Francisco 49ers and the Philadelphia Eagles. And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26. So here's the first drive now for the 49ers. And they will be led out by their 6'4 quarterback.
All in all, he was pretty solid in the victory in the wild card round and threw a couple of touchdowns. And when it comes to quarterback play, you'd always love spectacular. But in the playoffs, you'll take solid. And that's exactly what they're looking for from him again in this contest.
Now a play fake here on first down. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked off around the 37. And bring this one back to the 29. Now we've got whistles, and the man slow to get up here is Jones. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. Here's Vic following the interception. He'll buy some time right. Going for it all. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off with great anticipation. And the 49ers are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. Certainly not the cleanest of starts to this football game. Back-to-back plays yield turnovers in this first quarter.
So there's not much flow right now. A very choppy game. And I know this, it's a copycat league. We say it all the time about the NFL, but I'm not quite sure this is what they had in mind about something they wanted to emulate.
No, you don't want to emulate a turnover. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. He'll look to throw. Toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete. This defense, Charles, really played well in that win a week ago.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
Big hold to the 30. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. And the Eagles have recovered. We're scoreless after one. So first and 10 now from the 30. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Well, always so many storylines when you're playing January football. And, Charles, you talk about this offense, their head coach. It's his first time in charge in the playoffs. And I think you and I were both kind of surprised by his demeanor and specifically his comments and his confidence at the press conference where he really all but guaranteed a victory.
Yeah, I was a little bit taken aback because you don't normally see that. And on one hand, it's like, all right, cool. He feels great about his team. But on the other hand, I don't think it's in his best interest to do that. How many playoff games has he won again, Brandon?
None.
So there's your answer right there. I guess what he was trying to do was fire up his team, but he has to make sure he doesn't fire up the other guys because there have been a lot of coaches who've made guarantees that are no longer coaching in this league.
Could we get a touchdown in this first half after all? It's first and 10. They'll throw again. Here's Vic. It's caught. Touchdown, Eagles. Try-yard touchdown. And the Eagles are on the board first here in this division round matchup. Well, we had the scoreless first quarter of play. We sure didn't have to wait long into the second quarter to get some action on the scoreboard.
So was the first quarter a feeling out process? I mean, that was an interesting quarter, wasn't it? Because we had some action. We had some good play. just didn't have any points. So now it's game on.
Now the try here for the extra point. He's got it, and the Eagles lead at 7-0. So that drive, four plays. The result, Philadelphia in the end zone. Will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Well, the Niners going back on offense now late in this first half. And with 40 seconds to go, that's, you think, time enough to try to mount a drive should they decide to do so. It's complete to his big target, Crumpler. And it's a fumble. And it's picked up by the Eagles.
They should have put a stamp on me in the back.
And he's into the end zone. And it's a fumble return. And an Eagle touchdown. So the defense forces the fumble. They get the score, and a guy on defense becoming offensive there, Charles.
And you know they love that. Any guy on defense loves to pick up the ball and have it in his hands to try and score himself. In this case, that's exactly what happened.
He'll be singing in the shower postgame. Now the try here for the point after. It's good to make it 14-0. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football. We witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then running it into the end zone for six. So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again, following that fumble return for a score. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Well, the Niners going back on offense now late in this first half. And with him down two scores, you wonder if they might try and put something together, even if it's just to get into field goal range. And that one will fall incomplete. Clock here now, just under 30 seconds to go in this first half.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Loss of five, a big sack to bring up third down. So we've come upon halftime here, an abbreviated halftime show as we get rolling to quarter three. A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. A lane opens here. He's past the 30. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. Now Philadelphia ready to get going on offense again. And they've been the better of the two teams through two quarters of play, much to the chagrin of this home crowd.
Yeah, this score is a surprise to a lot of folks at home, although not to my dad. He predicted the visitors would win. And maybe to the folks in the stadium. But you know who is not a surprise to, partner? This team with the football. They were very confident coming in.
That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Continue to show why it pays to play at home in the postseason as they add on to their lead.
So, my man, another touchdown. They're looking like the number one seed that they earned throughout the year, looking pretty dominant right now.
We knew the road to the Super Bowl would run right through this stadium. Somebody's going to have to come in here and beat these guys. Good luck. I don't think it's happening this weekend.
No, definitely not this weekend. And for anyone else out there, bring your game.
Buyer beware. Whoa! He just yanked that one well to the left, and no good. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. This one fielded at the five. Now a hit and a loose football, and the Eagles have recovered. So problems compounding themselves here on the return. They just give up the touchdown, and now they lose the football.
Yeah, partner, things are starting to unravel a little bit for them right in front of our eyes. They're going to be looking for some answers, and quickly.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
Vic goes play action. They'll roll him out right. And a loose football. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers. And he'll be brought down at his own 10-yard line.
Well, number one on the list of things not to do when you're up three scores in the third, that right there, give the football away.
I love when you speak like that. You know how doctors talk about taking the Hippocratic Oath, first do no harm? You just did the football-cratic one right there. Don't give the ball away when you have a lead that you can lock this game down with.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. He finds his man complete. That's Lloyd. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. The gun. Here's Barber. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. One quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back to throw here. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. Now on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. On the return, here comes Lewis. Nice move by Lewis. Penalty stings big time there, wipes away a very good return.
And it worked out so hard because the goal is to give yourself some space for your offense to really work, try and gain an additional first down outside the 20 or 25-yard line. Instead, this one's going to come back.
And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Now a 2nd down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
As his old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
On 3rd down, Vic. Forced out to his left. He's going to look deep here for Ward.
And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made.
And one of the whistles for a timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds. Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's 1st and goal just outside the 5. Despite the late lead, Vic's going to throw. And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. Great play there. There to make the grab. And the Eagles are moving closer to a date now in the NFC Championship game as they're able to extend this 4th quarter lead.
Well, they certainly have the look of a team with something to prove, don't they? All week, as we prepared for this game, we kept reading about how they said they're going to play a full 60 minutes this week. Has nothing to do with their opponent. No disrespect intended, but they wanted to be people of their word, playing this thing all the way out, trying to finish it.
And this is going to be intercepted. Snags it for the pick, and the Niners will take over here at their own 12-yard line.
It's interesting that when it comes to 2-point conversions, even heavy run teams tend to throw the ball in these situations. In this case, this one was intercepted.
Yeah, they weren't fooled. They were ready for the pass, picked it off.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. This is just an exercise in futility. Do you even bother running a play here offensively?
I wouldn't.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off around the 37. And the Eagles come up with a late turnover. Statisticians, as this ball game is now officially over.